Hello dear children, welcome back.
Let us see the objective of module 2. Here in this module, we are going to understand the types of forest under natural vegetation. These are tropical evergreen forest, tropical deciduous forest, tropical rainforest, arid or desert forest, tidal forest and mountain forest. Thereafter, we will see the forest conservation, meaning and what are the forest policies made by government. At last, we will end up this session with the topic social forestry. So children, let's begin this module. So the first topic is types of forests. India is a landmass of great variety of natural vegetation. Himalayan heights are marked with the temperate vegetation. Western Ghats and Andaman Nicobar Islands have the subtropical rainforest. The Deltaic region have the tropical evergreen forest and mangrove trees. The deserts and the semi-desert areas of Rajasthan are known for cactus and thorny bushes. All these depend upon the variation in the climate and the type of soil. The vegetation of India changes from one region to another. Hence, Indian forests can be classified and categorized into following types: tropical evergreen forest, tropical deciduous forest, tropical rainforest, arid and desert forest, tidal forest and mountain forest. Now, let us see the features of tropical evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forest have an average rainfall of 200 cm and an average temperature of 24 degrees Celsius. It is found at hot and humid areas of India like Western Ghat, Andaman and Nicobar and Eastern Ghats. These forests are tall and dense with their height ranging from 45 to 80 meters. The trees compete and rise height to get sunlight. For example, rubber tree, coconut tree, ebony tree, mahogany and palm trees. Next comes the tropical deciduous forest. These type of forest have an average rainfall of 100 to 200 cm. They shed their leaves in summers due to the shortage of water. It is found at the Shivalik ranges, Ganga valleys, Western Ghat, Northern Ghat, North and East India. They are economically very important forest because we get majority of raw wood from these forests. For example, sal, teak, sisham, sandalwood, deodar and mahua. Now comes tropical dry forest. It is an average rainfall forest of 50 to 100 cm and there are less dense and size are 6 to 9 meter. Their roots are thick and long to use underground water and thick bark prevent undue evaporation. They are found in Punjab, Haryana, Madhya Pradesh, Eastern Rajasthan, Central Deccan Plateaus. Most of the areas are used for the agriculture. Dwarf, deciduous trees and long grasses grow in these regions. For example, neem, sisham, babool, peepal and mango. Arid or desert forest. Desert forests have an average rainfall of less than 50 cm. Prominent features of these forests are small leaves, thick bark, long roots. Indian wild dates is common in these desert and these are found at Western Rajasthan, Southwest Haryana, Punjab and some part of Gujarat. For example, small size kikar, babool, acacia, bushes and shrubs. Now comes tidal forest. These kind of forests grow along with the coastal line or the edges of deltas. Famous for mangrove and sundari trees. Consist of thick bushes and ferns. They are known as halophytes. That means tolerant of slanty. These trees are found at Sundarbans, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, deltas of Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. Next comes mountain forest. These forest varies considerably along with the slope of mountains. On the foothills of Himalaya up to the height of 1500 meters, evergreen trees like sal, teak, bamboo and cane grow abundantly. On the higher slope between 1500 meter to 3500 meters, temperate conifer trees like pine, fir, oak, maple, deodar, laurel spruce, kedar grow. Beyond these vegetation belts, alpine grassland appears up to snowfield. Now let us see the forest cover in India. According to Indian Forest Service report, that is IFSR 2015, the forest area covers 21.34% of the total land area of the country. Forest area is an area notified and recorded as the forest land, irrespective of the trees, while the actual forest cover area is occupied by the forest with the canopy. The area is based on the basis or the record of state's revenue department. While the other covers are based on the aerial photographs, both the forest areas and the forest cover varies. Lakshadweep has 0% of forest area. Andaman and Nicobar Island have 86.93%. On the other hand, most of the states have with less than 10% of the forest area that lies in the north and the northwest part of country. These are Rajasthan, Gujarat, Punjab, Haryana and Delhi. Now the next topic is forest conservation. Forests have an intricate interrelationship with the life and the environment. These provides numerous direct and indirect advantages to our economy and society. Hence, conservation of environment is very important for the survival of vital environment and the prosperity of human being. According to the Government of India, has proposed to have a nationwide forest conservation policy and adopted a forest policy in year 1952, which was further modified in year 1988. According to the new forest policy, the government will emphasize sustainable forest management. Now let us see the aims of forest policy. Bringing 33% of geographical area under forest cover, maintaining environmental stability and to restore forest where ecological balance was disturbed, conserving the natural heritage of the country, its biological diversity and genetic pool, check soil erosion, extension of desert lands and reduction of floods and droughts, increasing the forest cover through social forestry and afforestation on degraded lands, increasing the productivity of forest to make timber, fuel fodder and food available to the rural population dependent on forest, creation of massive people movement involving women to encourage plantation of trees, stop falling of trees and thus reduce pressure on existing forest. Now, the last topic of this module is social forestry. So children, the meaning of social forestry is the management and the protection of forest and afforestation on barren land with the purpose of helping in the environmental, social and rural development.
So that's all in this module, dear children. Remaining topic we are going to cover in the upcoming module of this chapter. Till then, stay happy, stay safe.
Now let us do some questionnaire. Sundari trees are found in tidal forest, desert forest, tropical evergreen forest or mountain forest. Next question is, ebony, mahogany, rosewood and rubber are the important trees of mountain forest, tidal forest, tropical evergreen forest or none of these. And the last question is, tropical rainforest are having annual rainfall of more than 300 cm, 200 cm, 100 cm or 50 cm. Answer all these questions in comment. Thank you for watching.